Thank you, Professor Chen. Good morning, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is my great pleasure to participate in the KGC, which hold on Kyoto with a beautiful city with rich culture, and it is the first time I visit. The topic I'm addressing today is a dual process approach for national personal health record system implementation, a new perspective on patient-centric care to universal health care. This is the outline. I will give you a snapshot of the Taiwan National Health Insurance System and the dilemma of the universal health coverage, and then the dual process approach and the key successful factor from the multiple perspectives will be introduced. The research will use the case study approach investigating the development of and the implementation of the dual process approach, and then identify the result by using the population-based NHI database. Before the 1995, the Taiwan already have several social insurance programs. Many focus on the working group. They are also coverage the including the healthcare coverage. In 1995, the government decided to set up a universal health insurance. The NHI consolidated the previous insurance program, and plus the 41% of the uninsured population, mainly the elders and the children. To achieve the universal health care, the government adopt a single-payer system running by the government. The NHI is running by the National Health Insurance Administration. The NHIA collects the premiums and contributes the health care provider to help the people can visit the doctor very convenient. And in this framework, there is no gatekeeper and no waiting list. Here are the main features in the NHI. The NHI provides a uniform package, and the coverage is very comprehensive. The provider, like I say in the previous slide, they are contracted with the NHIA, and they will be reimbursed by according the multiple payment program under the global budget payment scheme. The Taiwan NHI already achieved several important goals within the 23 years, including the universal coverage, and the people can very easy to access the service with affordable cost. The quality of care and the public satisfaction is very high. The public satisfaction is the 85.8% in 2017. It is the best one since 1995. Like Sarah already mentioned earlier, the three dimensions to consider when moving toward to the universal health coverage, Taiwan's status is quite good. Not only the population coverage is almost 100%, but also the benefit package is very convenient. The people only need to pay a little bit to see a doctor or visit the or can get the service from the inpatient. Professor Xiao and Professor Chen already identified the advantage of the single payer system in Taiwan. There are several important issues. I will mention that is one of them is the apply the information technology to improve healthcare efficiency and the quality. From the WHO service report, also identified that e-health system will benefit to the for a universal health coverage. Those kind of e-health coverage, including the health information system and the telehealth or the electronic health records system, also contributed to the universal health coverage. But when we see the, when we check the definition of the universal health coverage, the UHC tend to focus on the health care and the health service, often in the context of the health insurer. In fact, the UHC tend to focus on medical care without enough focus on the health promotion and the disease prevention. So when we, there are two arms of the healthcare system to across the lifespan of an individual. The one is the personal healthcare service. The another one is the public the health promotion and the prevention. I must mention that this is not a public issue but a personal issue for the people. In this slide, the United leading cause of death in 100 years already changed. The trend already changed. Since the epidemic disease is well be tr- is it ha- can be treated, the chronic disease stand up the most nowadays. In Taiwan, the chronic disease population is about 6.4 million in 1995 and become 10.8 million in the 2016. They increased by 67%, and in meanwhile the total medical expenditure and the drug expenditure will increase around three times. Taiwan is not like Japan. Taiwan is just into an aging society. However, Taiwan will become a super aging society with a skyrocketing speed. The impact on age, we can check in this slide. The 40% of the population will spend more about 37% of the medical expenditure, and after 17 years later, the 27% of the population will consume almost half of the medical expenditure. Because this trend, we need to redesign and rethink about the healthcare process from the visitor-centric to behavioral care. For in-person healthcare may be not the second, third, or even the last option for those kind of people. So that may be upset the physician, but this kind of process may meet the need of those kind of patient, and that will be help, maybe also help the doctor. So from this reason, like other country, the NHIA launched a national PHR system in recent year. Compared to the other country, the NHIA used a dual process approach to go to the goal. One is the My Health Bank system as a very powerful data-driven tool for the insurers. The another one is the medical system. Medical system is a cloud-based system can access by the healthcare provider. The meaning of the national PHR system is not only the liberated data for the provider. More important is the data to the patient themselves. So in this idea, the patient can lead the data sharing to be a digital gatekeeper for their data, for their health data, and the patient are empowered to manage their own data. So Taiwan launched the My Health Plan system as a web-based electronic medical record system for the system. However, it is not yet a PHR in the beginning. They are only contain 1 year's data in that kind of system. After 2 years, to enhance this system, NHI launched the second generation of the My Health Bank system to provide more than 3 years' data for the citizen, and a user-friendly interface for the citizen can download or use by the personal computer or the mobile device. The data come from the two parts. The one is the internal data. It's from the reimbursement reason, they collect the client data and put them into the system. And the NHI also encouraged the provider to provide the data is not put in the list of the reimbursement. And also the NHI negotiated with other government agencies, such as CDC, Health Promotion Administration, to collect those internal data input into the same platform to help the people can download or query in from a different way in the single system. The system is not only provided the query function, but also the user can download those kind of data in several different format, and also provide them can upload their own data by themselves. Right now, the registered user is almost 1 million, and the query is more than 8 million times. But when we check the usage, you can find that half of the user is only used once. And however, the more than 10% of the user are 18 user. Compared with the other country, the system is running by under the 5% of the population will be a registered user. But however, it's similar to the other country. We use the same opt-in way to build up this kind of national PHR system. The next step to improve the system is the NHI is going to release a software development kit to help the third party can ask to help their patient to access their own data. Before the medical system, the NHI established the pharma cloud system first. Then they integrate the medical data and upgrade the pharma cloud to the medical cloud in the 2014. And then released this system in the 2016 with a similar data of the My Health Bank. The system is very comprehensive, and they have put different period data for the different function. They are all rolling daily base data, like the same is also sent in the My Health Bank system. In the end of the 2017, the NHI encouraged the provider to upload the data of the examination result and the image. The medical cloud system can be accessed by the provider with the two methods, the online or the batch model. Different with the online model, the batch model can pre-download those kind of data to integrate it with the provider, their own health information system to help the people, they provide them more information for care of the people. But the NHIA only allow the provider to do that when they got the patient informed consent. The inquiry rate of the this system is almost 85%. It means it's very functional and its popularity for the provider. And the duplication prescription with Crohn's disease is reduced around one half from the 2014 to 2017. That the system is not only reduced the more than $10 million US dollars, but also help the patient safer. Right now, the NHI want to build up this kind of system to put the last mile, the image data into together. That will be a huge engineer because the data is very huge. We need to put it in the storage almost need to consume 500 terabyte per year. The dual process approach can be explained by the technology economic perspective. Usually, we can use the technology adoption to see what such a system why they are successful. However, it seems enough. So, in this research, we take the social political perspective, such as social exchange series and the resource dependent series. It will be better when we check this kind of series to put into this dual process approach. That, for example, for the usage to expand the usage of the My Health Bank, we can understand that the patient is seldom rewarded to do that under this kind of comprehensive benefit package in Taiwan. On the contrary, the provider will be pushed by the NHI under the global budget. And if the provider, they have more information technology resource, they will take the advantage of the less to benefit, to get more benefit from the NHIA. However, we need to be careful in discuss the social political perspective with this interactive series. The collaboration and the trust will be very important in this series. So the shared position and the patient's incentive are more effective than the incentive to the physician or patient only. The both multi perspective is useful for expanding the successful for the dual process approach. However, it's not capture the whole picture. In this data-driven platform, the data-driven innovation is very important. We can see the several examples, not only in the My Health Bank, but also in the Medi-Cal. The provider or the third party will improve the system and feedback to help the system better and better. For example, this is a startup company in Taiwan. They use the My Health Bank data, combine the device, upload the device data to come together and part with the private insurance company to help those people have diabetes and hope they can change their behavior to improve their health. So this dual, so from the, not only from the particle perspective to extend the successful factor, but also we can find that the dual process approach can fulfill the UHC goal with a target strategy. In this slide I mentioned before, use the dual process approach, we can cover not only the health service but also the health prevention in the, across the lifespan of the individual. So in conclusion, we think the national national PHR system should be changed and become a patient-centric system, as this kind of the system will be an ecosystem for the people they can lead the data share and help achieve the goal health for all. Combined with the national health insurance medical cloud and the My Health Bank system, and with the other data from the promotion and the prevention, we can integrate into a innovation health platform to help the people, help the multiple provider to take care of the patient, and by then to lead the data sharing. Not only the Taiwan, but also the other country, when we build the national PHR system, I think there is no perfect system, but only the better one. Thank you for your attention.